How many times have you sent an email asking someone a question and waiting for a reply, yet you hear absolutely nothing? Maybe a few days go by and then suddenly it dawns on you, oh, that's right, I should follow up with so-and-so. And maybe even when you sent out that very first email, you tried to send a reminder, maybe you added something to your calendar or something else, just so that you could remember in the future, but then that person replied back immediately, so that reminder was worthless. Well, today I want to share with you a super cool Gmail extension, which is going to help you increase your chances of getting replies to your emails. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And today I want to share with you something that I've discovered recently called Rebump for Gmail. Rebump is all about sending automatic replies to people who have not yet responded to your emails. So let me show you how Rebump works. So here I've got an example email. I'm wanting to set up a meeting with someone and I'm saying, hi Ken, let's continue our discussion so we can iron out the details of this contract. When would be a good time to get together? Now, in a normal course of action, I would just hit send and hope that Ken would reply to me in a short amount of time. But I'm gonna use Rebump. There's a little icon down here. This is the Rebump icon, and I'm gonna check this off. But you probably wanna understand what on earth is Rebump going to do after I hit send now. Well, let me take you into the Rebump interface and explain to you what a bump actually is. So here we have what is called a bump sequence. And the way that this is designed is that if that individual does not reply to my email, there will be a series of follow-up emails coming from my email address, not Rebump, but from my own email address, just giving them a gentle reminder. So here I have a default sequence in order, but keep in mind, all of this is editable. You can change the frequency, the days out from each bump, you can change the messages themselves, and I'll show you how to do that in just a second. But in this default example, after I send my original email, if that person does not reply to me within 3 days, Rebump will send this automatic email. I don't have to do anything. It's going to do it on its own. Hi, just wanted to make sure you got the email below. Thanks. Something pretty simple and straightforward. Now, if we continue on with this bump sequence, if I do not receive a reply 4 days after bump one, or over here, 7 days in total, right? This is 7 days after the initial email, well, then a second bump will be sent, a second email. Just checking in, wanted to make sure you got my email. And there's actually 4 bumps in this complete sequence, day 14 and even day 21. They're all worded a little bit differently. And remember, you don't have to have a 4-bump sequence. You don't have to use this text here. It is all editable. But the great thing is that if this individual does reply to me before day 3, none of these bumps go out. Nothing additional will be sent. Maybe it needs bump one and bump two, but let's say in between bump two and bump three, that's when the individual replies to me. Once again, everything here is canceled. So it's not as if they're going to be receiving reminders after they have followed up with you or after they've replied to you. So let me show you just how easy this is. You can create multiple bumps, different bumps for different purposes. I've created one here called proposal. So if I go into my proposal bump, the one that I just edited not too long ago, you can see that I've changed the time frame, right? When you're sending out a contract, you want to follow up in a shorter amount of time. So I'm saying after 2 days, if I don't hear a reply, I want them to send out this email. And the other nice thing about Rebump is that you can actually add personalization. So here I've added the auto first name, right? This is going to be the first name from your email contacts. So hi, first name. I just wanted to check in and see if you've had time to review my proposal. If you have any questions, just let me know. And if we continue on to this proposal bump sequence, you can see that it's specific, right? Let's just hit edit here for a second here, just to show you that, again, you can add formatting to these emails very much like you would in Gmail itself. Here I can change the days, right? How many days from the previous bump that I want to add. And over here, even to the right, here's some of that personalization, right? The auto first name or auto last name, if I want to add that as well. So in this case, I've got a bump sequence which is very specific to a contract or for sending a proposal. So let's go back to Gmail for just a moment here, and I want to show you exactly what's happening. Now, let me uncheck rebump for a second here, and I'm going to check it again. So I'm going to check it here, and I want to show you up here in the BCC line. Whenever this box is checked, it's actually adding this unique email address, this special bump email address to the BCC line. Now, what makes this so important is not only is this is how rebump works, but it allows you to use it on mobile. I know a lot of times we install an extension for Gmail and we love it, we use it, but then we're disappointed that we can't use it on our smartphones. Well, that's not a problem with rebump. All you need to do is use this email address in the BCC line when you're composing an email on mobile, and the same functionality exists. Now I'm going to uncheck it for just a second because you'll notice that there's a little drop down here, bump sequence. So here you can see, here's the default and here's the proposal. So I can choose between the two, which one I want to use. In this case, I do want to stick with the default because I'm not sending a contract along. I just want to talk about the contract. So I've checked it and now I can send it and I can see what's going on. Now, if I go back into my rebump account, you're probably wondering, well, how do I manage all of these rebumps? Well, here we go. Under the emails tab within rebump, here you can see a list of all of my active bump sequences. So these are the emails that I have sent out. It shows me the date, recipient, subject, all the important information I need to find out which email is which. And then it's also telling me where it is in the sequence. So the last bump is actually the original email. None of these have actually been bumped, but it's telling me exactly when that person can expect to receive the next bump. It even has a nice visual indicator here that as it goes through the bump sequence, these little circles will light up and change color so you know exactly where they are in that sequence. And of course, I can just select cancel here if I don't want these bumps to happen at all. If I just want to cancel it, I can select that. I can do it in bulk as well here on the left-hand side of the screen. Now, I also wanted to make sure that you can customize when your bumps are sent out, because I know some of you are probably asking, Scott, I deal with business people. They're typically dealing with me during business hours. I don't want to send this out at 3 a.m. I don't want to send it out on the weekend. No problem. Rebump has you covered. So here you can adjust a number of your bump settings, including bump days and times. So I'm going to uncheck Sunday and Saturday, and then I'm also going to check this one. So I only want to send bumps between 8 a.m. and 6 p.m. Of course, I can change these if I want, but now I can ensure that my bumps will be sent out during typical business hours and a typical business week. They're not going to be receiving something at, you know, Sunday morning at 2:30 a.m. And of course, the client's going to be thinking, why on earth is someone sending me a reminder at this time of the day? So I encourage you to check out Rebump for Gmail. Rebump comes with a 30-day free trial. You can try out all of the features within Rebump, including the ones that I've shown you in today's video. If you do like the extension, if you do like the service, Rebump is only $5 a month afterwards. I hope you enjoyed this video. I look forward to your questions and your comments below. And remember to subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. Remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.